What is up, nerds? Brandon from Nerd Locker. We are here at San Diego Comic-Con, and I'm here with Mr. Robert Venditti. Now, you are writing for Valiant currently with XO Manowar. For those that have not hopped on this book yet, can you give us a little summary about it?
Yeah, sure. XO Manowar is about Arik of Dacia, who is a 5th century Visigoth, who grows up sort of under the heel of the Roman Empire. He gets kidnapped by aliens from his own time and is taken into space where he's kept a slave. And when he finally escapes with their highly advanced suit of sentient armor and returns to Earth because of time dilation, it's the modern day. So he's at the same time the most technologically advanced and the most primitive person on the planet. And so that's kind of the conflict that really appealed to me about the series when I was asked to write it, was that's not, you know, a storyline that you see a lot. And so I like the challenge of that and sort of the blend of historical fiction and science fiction and all that. So.
Now, being that you were asked to write this, what was it like hopping on a character that has had a following before?
Yeah, I mean, that was part of the challenge. You know, I didn't know XO Manowar previously. I didn't start reading comics until 2000, so the whole sort of Valiant thing had already come and gone by that time. So it was an entirely new property to me, but I was aware it had a really big fan base. And from the get-go, my goal was always to appeal to new readers, but also, you know, do something fresh that would be new to the old readers, but that they would still enjoy and felt like was true to that original core concept. And I think that's what Valiant's mission statement as a company sort of is. Like, let's take these properties with these great core concepts, let's update them, let's modernize them, let's appeal to modern audiences, but at the same time, let's not jettison all the things that made them great to begin with, because a great high concept is a great high concept no matter what decade you're writing it in. So.
See, that was actually my next question, was being that Valiant's taking all these older characters and now kind of giving them a little boost of, you know, renewing them to people, why should people be reading Valiant right now?
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of reasons. I mean, first and foremost, the most obvious one would be they are just really good books. You know, I mean, I think Harbinger is probably the best book on the stands today. It's just truly phenomenal, better even than the ones that I write, you know. I mean, it's just the stuff that they do with character and the stuff that they do with these concepts. And also, what's nice about their line is it's an entry point to get into a new universe as it builds. But also, with the span of titles that they have, they all are each in their own genre, you know? So you have something like XO that's, you know, pretty cosmic sci-fi. You have something like Bloodshot that's more of like an action movie. You have something like Harbinger, which is much more of a character study. And so each of the books is different in its own genre in a sense, but they're all unified through this universe that's being built. So it's an opportunity to get in and read a lot of different material, but still have it all linked together in a really nice, cohesive way.
XO's been going on for a little bit now, and it was something online saying that you're introducing another older character into the story?
You're talking about the new arc that's coming up?
Yes.
Yeah, Eternal Warrior is going to be in the new arc that's coming up. And he is a character who, as his name suggests, is an Eternal Warrior. He sort of has been around for thousands and thousands of years. And Arik knew him back in the 5th century. And now they're seeing each other again. And it's a nice counterpoint, because on the one hand, you have somebody like Arik, who went from A to B and just sort of jumped and didn't have the benefit of all that evolution of cultures in the interim, whereas the Eternal Warrior has seen all that history. And so it's sort of the difference between knowledge and experience, you know? So that's kind of the things that we're going to be playing off. And it also reunites and has this confrontation with these two, you know, A-list Valiant characters who had a confrontation back in the original Valiant era that was sort of a very, you know, beloved storyline. So I'm looking forward to be able to tell that in a different way now, and just like I was saying before, you know, stay true to what the original core concepts did, but hopefully do something new and something fresh that new readers and old readers won't see coming. So
Speaking of something new, I'm going to jump to DC for a minute and ask you about Relic. That's the new villain they're building up in Green Lantern, which you are behind. What can you tell us about him?
Yeah, I'm really excited about Relic. It's a character that Billy Tan and I created for this sort of larger storyline that's going to happen in the month of October called Lights Out, where it's going to start with Green Lantern and go through all four Green Lantern titles and end with the Green Lantern annual at the end. So it'll be one month long story. And he's a villain they haven't faced before. He's more of a scientist than somebody who is super powered or anything like that. Like all of his sort of strength comes from this formidable mind and this technology that he surrounded himself with. And he has a particular beef with the Lanterns, and so that's what we're going to learn throughout the course of the storyline. And there's going to be a lot of revelations, not just in terms of the Green Lantern characters and the Green Lantern books, but also expanding on the mythology and all that kind of stuff. So,
sounds good, man. Well, yeah, that's about all I have for you. Thank you very much for your time.
No, I appreciate it. Thank you. Take care. This is Robert Venditti, and you're watching Nerd Locker, the place for your inner nerd.